In this video, I want to tell you about three puzzles by MicroPuzzles, a company that I discovered recently. If you're interested in their product, you can just Google MicroPuzzles and you'll find their website. They make these very small puzzles that are all 150 pieces each, very small pieces, so that the final puzzle, when put together, is the size of a postcard. They come in these sort of medical tubes, which also means that the image is not on a flat surface, but fear not, if you want to have a larger image, they all have the code here that you can scan for a full image that you can see on your phone or tablet or whatever. So I was curious about the company and about their puzzles, and I tried three other puzzles. These are the ones that they solved that I'm going to show you next. And I have to tell you, I really, really enjoyed them. Such fun little project, especially because I was working on a large 4,000 piece projects. And so it was nice to take breaks from that to solve some of these puzzles, which, however, thanks to, not in small part to their small size, they present their challenges. They're not trivial. Another thing is that all three puzzles that I solved by them, and I assume then that's what they have in their company, is a standard thing. All pieces are the same, meaning with the exception of the edges, all pieces in all puzzles are these pieces that, for lack of a better word, have two male connections and two female connections. I don't know if that's particularly okay, but I use that analogy to explain, you know, the kind of the classical puzzle piece that you have in mind when you think of a puzzle piece, that kind. And so the entire puzzle, Every piece has that shape, with different proportions, some larger, some smaller, but all the same general structure, and just one vertical, one horizontal. And this is the puzzle that you see here, is the stained glass tree that I really enjoyed. As for the final image, I find this to be the most beautiful one, a really attractive image, very, very nice. And that was fun and not too hard, not too simple to solve. It presented just the right amount of challenge for a puzzle that, you know, I want to work for an hour or so and be happy that I see it, that I have it, and I see the completed thing. Also, the fit is very good, because you can see they don't come loose easily once you clip them together. So look at how adorable these pieces are. That's how small they are. And just nice, bright colors. The piece is a little thin, as you can expect for something this small, but that's okay. Otherwise, it would be almost the thickness of the size of the puzzle. Nice, beautiful, and again, a nice level of challenge. Another one that was interesting that I solved, this one, the birds on a wire, which is both the easiest when it comes to the central subject, and then pretty tricky when it comes to these other sections here between the bodies of the birds and the edges. There are many, not too many, but there's a number of these white pieces. Again, the shape is almost the same. You really can't tell if one piece is in the right position or the wrong position just by looking at them, because the difference in the proportions is so minimal. And the same actually applies to the edges, that were not all that easy to put together, precisely because you're almost all white. And again, the connections really almost all look the same. And so I had to look very carefully at the image here, the pattern of the dots, which again presented me with a level of challenge that I enjoy. Because at this point, after I did the purse, they're so cute, so humorous, so fun. And then I had the little bit of extra work to do. One of the rare puzzles in which I did the edges last or towards the very end. Doesn't happen often. This is one such puzzle. Fun, challenging, part of it pretty challenging, part of it fairly simple. When you put it together, I'd say the level of challenge is similar to this one, although this one was more evenly spread. The most challenging puzzle by MicroPuzzles that they solved is this one, the Italian Galleria. Beautiful, gorgeous, I almost feel like, oh, I wouldn't mind solving the 1,000-piece version and put it on the wall. But really, really nice. As you can imagine, there's a little challenge here because of this. But then actually the buildings, I expected them to be a lot easier. So I'll do this part easier, more easily, and then this will be the challenge. These also were a lot trickier than I expected. The only part that was easy to identify put together was this central section of the galleria, because it clearly has a very different pattern. The most challenging of them all, but that means that instead of solving in an hour, maybe it was an hour and a half, which is, again, perfectly, perfectly fun. Fine and fun. Beautiful puzzles, and just great puzzles these days. So maybe you're not going on vacation very much because of the pandemic, but maybe you're going camping. Maybe you're camping in your backyard. This could be the kind of fun puzzle that you bring with you as you're doing your safe, socially distant trips for the summer. Really, really enjoyable. I definitely want to try more puzzles from this company, MicroPuzzles, because these ones were a lot of fun and I really enjoyed solving them. MicroPuzzles, small size, great fun.